So one thing you might have done is look at the Python documentation. And Hashable here is a link. If you click on it, you'll get to the glossary that explains what Hashable means. It says that an object is hashable if its hash value never changes during its lifetime. That means it has an underscore hash method, and it can be compared to other objects. This is still quite a difficult definition. It's not something that tells you very clearly what's hashable and what's not. The second part of it is more useful. It says that all of Python's immutable built-in objects are hashable. That makes sense because their value doesn't change. They can map to the same object using hash. And none of the immutable containers are. And their examples are ones that you should be familiar with, lists and dictionaries, as mutable containers that are not hashable. And the reason it's important for things to be hashable, well, we've seen this with dictionary keys. If we want to use a hash function to look up the value of a key, well, we need to know that that key can't change. If it could change when we did our lookup in the dictionary, if you remember what we did with dictionaries, well, we had a key. That was the input to some hash function along with the dictionary size. And that would give us a mapping to some bucket. If the hash of the key could change, so if the key was something that could be mutated, well, the next time we look it up, if the key has changed, we're going to hash it and we're going to look in the wrong bucket. So that's why things need to be hashable, to be put in a dictionary. That's the same thing for sets. And if the value of an item could change, well, that would break the representation of the set.